Alright. First and foremost, I'm going to say all praises be to our Bashmel Shai Bashmel Kalkadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of great milestone, and shalom to the sincere elect, teaching the truth and faith and sincerity through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashmel Shai Bashmel Kalkadash. Hey man, you know, there's some interesting information that's coming out, some interesting conversations that have been taking a place within, you know, companies that employ people, man. You know, in terms of this C19 jab vaccine, you know, just information that's coming out. You know, what's interesting about this is that I've realized over the past week, like in the news, the main thing they've been speaking about is that in terms of these jobs and companies requiring you a jab. Yeah, it's like a lot of it will be down to the particular kind of company. Now the interesting thing about it is something that we've been saying for a long time, that in terms in particular of this vaccine, because you know we know with the market, at least, that will be instituted worldwide. But obviously, as we can see, is that there's a system that's being put in order before they implement that mark of the beast, and that way of testing it out is through what the vaccine, man. Now basically what they were saying is that most work companies have their own right to basically will require you to have a vaccine in order to work. So that's interesting. So like now, even if they don't say everyone at a certain age must receive the vaccine, which that's what they already started to do, like another route and angle of convincing people is by what their work. And as you can see during the week, there was even conversations on basically if you don't get the jab, certain shops can demand and require you to have proof of getting a jab to enter into the shop. So that shows you that everything that we've been speaking about is happening. So let me play the clip.
No jab, no job. A few UK companies are considering making COVID jabs a condition of employment.
So there's actually talks of UK companies of making getting a jab a condition of employment.
But such a requirement could lead to discrimination against people who are unable to or choose not to receive a vaccine. So what is the legal position for employers? Can companies insist on a jab?
As of today, it is my view that employers could not insist on a jab for currently employed employees. That would be a breach not only potentially of the Equality Act and employment rights law generally, it would also be a breach of the public.
We have to understand, as of now, you know, that's always what Esau does. You know, he's like, yeah man, as of now simply means what? As of right now. But eventually, they can put certain exemptions, certain laws, certain things into place, which could change that. Remember, the scripture says, Esau speaks with a forked tongue, man.
Health Control Diseases Act 1984, which actually prohibits any sort of mandatory treatment, such as vaccines. If an employer was to, for example, dismiss an employee that's currently on the payroll because they refused to get a jab, it is highly likely that would constitute unfair dismissal.
What about asking new staff to have the jab?
for new prospective employees right now, because there is no jurisprudence, there's no law from Parliament, it really is going to be watch this space. The parties are free to negotiate their contract, an employment contract just like any contract. However, the employer has much greater bargaining power than the employee. So they start insisting.
See? So, yeah. So, like, the whole point I was making is that, amen. So, essentially, what she's saying here is that, you know, that certain kind of companies can have new members of staff who apply for a certain job have it in their contract that to work this job, blah blah blah, you must have the jab. Do you see? Meaning, you might apply for a job, and the whole spectrum of that contract of employment, it's already said, hey, to get the job, you must get the jab. Now, what's also important to understand is that they as well can, you know, negotiate new terms and conditions for a contract, man. Right? You know, they even might give you an incentive. Okay, you know, if you want a pay rise, well, we have to insist that in your new contract of a new wage bill, right? You have to get that Maxine. So before I continue. Because, you know, people are like, oh, you guys talk about the same thing. Well, you know why we talk the same thing? Because we're a watchman. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word of my at my mouth and give them warning from me. So that's what we have to do. We have to give you that a warning. Because if we give you that warning, that understanding gives you that confidence, you know. That faith through the Spirit of the Lord, which of course is a gift. But I'm saying, just understanding how things are coming to pass and how they're playing things out, it all, you know, is good to know. I mean, at the end of the day, if a person says to you, yeah man, tomorrow morning I'm gonna come in your house 2 a.m. and kick down, you know, your door, of course you would prefer to obviously know what he's about to do. You know what I mean? It won't make sense just saying, nah, man, I prefer to not know. Having an understanding is way better than not having it. You know what I mean? When it says, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning. Right, and now in this verse, when it says of the wicked, it ain't talking about of Esau, it's speaking about of Israel. Nor speak is to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Yeah, man, so that's why we push forth this truth. Because it's our job, right, to make you know, you basically understand and know what's taking place, man. All right? Let me go back to the video anyway. Why does my phone do this, bro?
That they want to write this into the contract of employment, which I understand some firms have already started making preparations for that.
Employers, by law, are obliged to provide a safe workspace. So could COVID vaccinations help protect vulnerable people in the workspace?
Is an employer, as part of their general duties, does have a legal obligation to maintain a safe workplace.
See? they have the right to maintain a safe workspace. So if the employer decides that for your own safety and for the safety of other staff, it is required that you receive a vaccine, then effectively it's mandatory. It's mandatory to work in that workplace. Now, you might say, if they say that, I'll go to another job, which of course you have to understand is that all these companies and all these companies and things like that, you know, all these companies and stuff like that are all in one league anyway, you know, they're all in one league, you know. But don't you think the top companies are now having meetings?
Be that in the Employment Rights Act 1996 or the health and safety legislation from the 1970s. So you can construct an argument saying that they could make that a reasonable management instruction as part of their overall responsibility and duty of care, not only to their employees, but to their clients and customers.
So will COVID contracts actually happen?
What the issue is whether generally employers will be permitted to go down this line, and I don't believe they will. For a start, employment law really is about what is reasonable both on the employer and the employee. I foresee that it will end up in the employment tribunal very quickly indeed, and we will eventually get a body of case law which will set out essentially the legal position as the courts view it. Of course, another possibility which can't be ruled out, bearing in mind that Downing Street a few days ago, I believe it was the Prime Minister's official spokesperson, said that this would be discriminatory. So one option, of course, is for Parliament to grasp this nettle here and now and seek to legislate what the position is, and then the courts and everybody else would be bound by the primary legislation.
See, so essentially what you're saying is that basically they could easily pass a law on either way that would aid the court's power. So whether, you know, it's a law for or against it, they could easily negotiate some form of a standpoint, man.
So I think to summarise, it's watch this space.
See, these conversations are happening, and this is something that we've been speaking about, man. This is Psalms 94 and 20. Shall the throne of iniquity have fellowship with thee, which frameth mischief by a law? And what's the throne of iniquity? It is the rulership of Esau, right? The scripture says when the wicked are multiplied, that transgression increaseth, but the righteous shall see their fall. You know, so they cause sin. Now, if you go into the word frameth, right, it is to form, to fashion of human activity, you know, so it says what? To be predetermined, to be preordained, to be formed, creative, right, which frameth mischief by a law. Now, if you go into the word mischief, it says wearing effort, hence worry of whether a body or mind, grievousness, iniquity. You know what I mean? So by them creating this law, it is essentially to stress out people, man. Right, to have them in slavery. I mean, if you're in slavery, are you not stressed out? Of course you are. But that's what's happening, man. There's an article as well. British firms draw up no jab, no job contracts ahead of lockdown easing. British companies are beginning to draw up no jab and no job contracts after the government yesterday admitted it was up to businesses to decide how to enforce vaccinations requirements. So that's so it's like so if you work for them big major companies, you know for 100% that soon gonna be in place. Barchester Healthcare, which runs more than 200 headquarters across the country, said it will not hire new staff who refuse COVID-19 vaccination on non-medical grounds. Some UK law firms, which declined to be named, added that some companies were also looking at requiring existing employees to have coronavirus jabs before returning to the office. It comes after Pimlico Plumbers last month became the first companies to announce it would introduce a no jab, no job policy in an interview with CEAM last month. Charlie Mullins, founder of the plumbing firm, said lawyers were currently working on making vaccinations against coronavirus mandatory for its 400 strong workforce. So you have to understand, if one company can work with lawyers to make vaccines mandatory in their company, who's to say other smaller companies can't do the same, or other bigger companies can't do the same? We are going to change their contracts to say, wherever the wording might be, that you are required to receive to have a vaccine, it's going to be standard. See, so what confrontation, what this will essentially cause now, is that people who haven't got jobs will be ready on demand to replace you, right? People who haven't got jobs will be ready on demand to replace you, and people who do have jobs will have their anxiety, right, of losing their jobs. That shows you that this was a perfect devil, man. Because now, people who don't have a job, right, will be just waiting for you to lose your job because of not taking it. So, although now there are no jobs, a lot of jobs soon will be available if you're willing to take the vaccine. However, his comments raise questions over the legality of no jab, no job policies, with the government insisting companies could not make vaccinations mandatory. But you have to understand, right, even though it's not a mandate, it's not a mandatory thing that you work there. So it's simple. If you don't want it, okay, cool, well, you have to find a job somewhere else, because for our health terms and conditions, it works that you have to take that, man. No. So yeah, man. No. So anyway, man. I can't go into the Yeah, anyway, it says, yeah, Sarah Calderwood, employer lawyer at Slater Healis, told CEAM that though employers should offer to provide immunizations to those who are not already immunized, employees are at liberty to refuse immunizations. If employers want to make the COVID vaccine a contractual requirement, changes in the terms of contract would need to be agreed by staff. Employers enforcing this change without employees express an implied agreement would be in breach of the contract, and employees would be entitled to resign and claim constructive unfair dismissal. See? And it says, while this policy isn't in the pipeline for many businesses, there will be many conversations taking place to establish how and when the businesses can invite their staff back into workplace safely. See? So these conversations are happening, man. And it shows you that Esau is the devil, man. Right? This is Job 9 and 24. Right? Come on, man. Them sit them on Satan's side. This is Job 9 and 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? So the earth is given into that hand of the wicked, man. And because of Esau is putting these wicked practices into place, because it's given into his hand, right? And this further on, you know, should really serve as a preparation mentally for the time of trouble. Because from the time of trouble, they're gonna do this the exact same thing with the mark of the beast. But let me start with this. This is Ecclesiastes 10:1. A wise judge will instruct his people, and the government of a prudent man is well ordered. As the judge of the people is himself, so are his officers. And what manner of man the ruler of the city is, such are all they that dwell therein. An unwise king destroyeth the people, and essentially his laws and practices are being put in a place to have people in further servitude. But through the prudence of them which are in authority shall the city be inhabited, man. So all these laws and these practices are being put into place, man. Which is, you know, that's why now ain't the time to, you know, to be inspired by fear. And now's the time to be inspired by faith. Because all these things are happening, and it can't be stopped. Because it won't be, because it's prophecy. But that's why it's about praying to the Lord, you know. Like a very good prayer is that Psalm 51. And as well, a very good prayer is the Lord's prayer. You know, like, if you can, like, if you put in this truth for a couple months or like a year or so, learn the Lord's prayer in Hebrew, man. It's a powerful prayer. Because in this time when, because we're about to come in a time where jobs going to be lost, cars going to be lost, homes, such things. Right? But through faith, the Heavenly Father is going to provide us with our daily bread. This is Revelation 3 and 10. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Now, that hour of temptation is that mark of the beast, right? Which is the RFID chip implantable, which at some point will be amalgamated into this system and be the new form of payment in this global economy when it comes to a crash. But when it says, I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, if you go into the word keep, it says to attend carefully, to take care of, to guard. It says to keep one in a state of which he is, to observe, to reserve, to undergo. And so when it says to attend to carefully, to take care of, they're talking about them angels being sent within our lives to protect us in this time. because this hour of temptation, which is when basically everyone has to make a choice between Esau and his system or serving the Lord. And this Maxine is the first step in that time of temptation, man. Right? So with that, I'm going to say, hey, man, keep going, keep praying, keep staying strong. And we're going to say, all praises be to Yahweh, Shema Shai, Ba Shema Kakadash, double on as possible, and all this great millstone. Until next time, I'm going to say, Shalom.
No sit there, I sit and sigh.